The festive season is usually a time for joy, but for many it can be a really difficult period. Some might be experiencing grief, the loss of a loved one, loneliness, financial strain, just not feeling like they're able to provide the Christmas that they wanted to. So during a time like this, it's important to try and focus on self-care and how you can better your well-being. So here are my 12 tips for the 12 days of Christmas. Number one, let go of the expectations of others. You might feel that pressure of other people's expectations on you. You know, have you bought enough presents? Have you got a big enough tree? Have you made the perfect Christmas dinner? But remember that someone else's expectation of you is theirs and not yours. So if you are starting to feel disappointed today, take the time to reflect on your own expectations. You know, focus on what matters to you and your own motivations. Number two, find something to be optimistic about, even if it is a difficult time. It is perfectly normal and acceptable to feel low and down at times, but practicing things like gratitude might help you find those little wins in your day, which can help you notice the good. Now, one way to establish this into your daily practice is to keep a journal, a gratitude journal. And what I suggest is today, at the end of the day, write down 10 things that you're grateful for. It might be as something as simple as, you know, a lovely warm cup of tea or someone opening the door for you, or, I don't know, your bus being there on time. Whatever it is, just write it down and reflect on those small wins. Number three, giving. Do something kind for others. If you have the time, perhaps think about giving back to your community, broaden your perceptions of the world and gain a unique sense of purpose by serving those around you. And helping others often helps us to feel happier in ourselves. So perhaps today, reflect on the act of kindness that you could do today for someone else. Number four, exercise. With the increased endorphins that you get from exercising, it's not just the physical benefits you get, but also the mental health benefits you get from exercise. The NHS recommends you perform 150 minutes of moderate activity a week or 75 minutes of vigorous activity a week. So get those trainers on and make a dent into that weekly quota today. And if you're not feeling cardio workouts, that's okay. Try some stretching and strengthening exercises, maybe go do some yoga, because you might find that the meditative effects of yoga might also be helpful for you. Number five, carve out time for yourself. The festive period is full of activities, you know, parties, events, ferrying your kids around to different places. But in this time, you also need to be able to say no. We often just feel obliged to say yes when we're asked by loved ones and colleagues to do things, but it can lead to stress, burnout, anxiety. So learning to say no might feel really difficult, but by doing it, you'll then get more time for your own self-care. So today, practice saying no, politely but with confidence. Number six, pace yourself. Not everything needs to be done now or with haste. It can be a bit of an art to find the proper speed for every activity and to determine which activities can actually just be broken down into smaller, more manageable short-term goals. There's also benefit in taking pause to allow for productivity. Now, although Christmas is only one day, the actual festive period is long, so do just check in with your own physical, emotional, and mental levels today. And if you do need it, just take a nap, go for a walk, give yourself a break to give yourself that perspective that you might need just to adjust any of your goals. Remember that if things get difficult, you can delegate and do reach out for support if you need it. Number seven. Deck the halls. You might not be feeling it this year, but it can be hard not to find the joy in Christmas decorations and tinsel. Perhaps even just finding a new skill like making your own wreath might help, because by picking up a new skill and working on a new project, you might gain confidence and a sense of purpose and give you something fun to focus on. Number eight, switch off. We are on our phones fairly constantly with a stream of information always being showered at us. So it can be very easy just to spend hours scrolling through social media and online, and you think you're sitting there relaxing, but actually your mind isn't. So proactively switch off your phone today when you don't need it. Go outdoors. There are these concepts called green and blue health, and it's a concept of being outdoors and being in nature's green areas or near bodies of water can positively impact our health, both mentally and physically. There have been a number of studies comparing urbanized areas versus natural settings, and the natural settings consistently reap greater rewards. Even if you live in built-up areas, research does suggest that just a local green or a local park might be enough to de-stress you. So take a little bit of time off today just to walk into your local park or go for a little forest stroll and see how natural healing might help you. Number 10, box breathe. Now, this method of breathing is used to reduce anxiety. You breathe in slowly for 4 seconds. You hold that breath for another 4 seconds, and then you slowly exhale for 4 seconds. And then you repeat that again until you start to feel calmer. So if you are feeling anxious, take a few minutes today to do some meditative box breathing. Number 11, it's an easy one, but laugh. Laughter can reduce our stress hormones, reduce our blood pressure and our pulse. So put on your favourite comedy on TV and just allow time for a proper belly laugh. And finally, number 12, prioritise your sleep. Evidence supports the need for 7 to 8 hours of sleep every night, and those that regularly get less than this are at increased risk of a number of serious health problems. As well as it being bad for your physical health, we know that not being able to sleep can really reduce your emotional resilience. So ensure you try and prioritise and optimise your sleep as much as you can. And you can do this by following a number of sleep hygiene methods, including relaxation, avoiding a blue light before bed, so light from your phone and laptop and devices, taking warm baths, making sure your bedroom is a haven for sleep, and avoiding caffeine.